without fear before our enemies. We have sworn an oath to restore Biafra, or we die in the process. There will be no retreat and no surrender. If the option they give to us is to seek our restoration by violence, the every living thing living in the zoo will be destroyed. All the animals will be destroyed. It's a promise and a pledge we're making to them. They must understand that we just don't love our country. We are fanatical about Biafra. We will do everything humanly possible to ensure that Biafra comes. It is either the flag of Biafra is raised up or I am lowered into the grave. One of the two must happen. It is better for this heaven and this earth not to exist than for Biafra not to come to pass. We dedicate it into the hands of Chukwu Abiyama, the creator of the heavens and the earth, because only him decreed that we should exist as a race, and only him has the say to decide and to determine if we are to survive or not. We don't rest our hopes in any man. We don't believe that any country can do anything for us. We are going to reaffirm our faith in the supremacy of the creator of the heavens and the earth, Chukwu Abiyama, upon to whom and in whom every glory and honor belongs to. That's why we worship him and nothing else and no other. We worship the one true living God. That is who we worship. That is why we were created. We are not like any other people. We have been chosen by Chukwu Abiyama to serve him. We have been chosen by the creator of the heavens and the earth that we may serve him. That is why in our names it contains every praise imaginable. Every praise imaginable to the Most High is contained within our names, because we are very special people. We are here to reaffirm and reiterate that. We are here to ensure that this very march towards our freedom cannot be hindered. Any obstacle on our way, real or imagined, man or woman, adult or child, anything it is, once you are an impediment to the restoration of the sovereignty of Biafra, you will be destroyed completely and totally in every way imaginable. We do not forgive. There is no forgiveness in our dictionary. We are here to ensure that the death of 3.5 million people is not forgotten. It is to them that I owe every ounce of loyalty and obligation. They are not here to offer any advice or to ask us to forgive Gowon. They are not here to ask us to forgive Haruna. They are not here to ask us to forgive the Yoruba people and the Wolowo family. The reason why we exist is to ensure that their memory, that they can never ever be forgotten, that their memory will linger on forever, that as long as man walks this earth, this world will remember the 3.5 million people that they killed, men and women that did nothing, children that were innocent. Their only crime is to be blessed by God. That is the only crime they have committed. As those children were being slaughtered, as they were being starved to death by a very wicked and cruel world spearheaded by Awolowo, everybody looked on and did nothing. Instead of them to help us, they ensured that our absolute blockade from land, air and sea was absolute, that we may die, that the children of God may die. But lo and behold, Chukwu Abiyama determined that we cannot die, that we cannot perish, because we are his own. Despite all our iniquities, despite all our sins, he made us in his image. He gave us that very edict to worship him, and that is what we do every blessed day on this radio station, without fail and without the fear of any human being, not less of an animal in the zoo. We are here to worship Chukwu Abiyama. For those who don't understand what Chukwu Abiyama means, he is the creator, the supreme creator of the heavens and the earth. And to him, we owe everything that we are. And upon him, and to him, does every honor and glory belong to. This is Radio Biafra. As I wait for the barrister to join me, we must once again welcome you wherever you are, across every...